In this match, this has been the feud around the East Coast here in so many promotions. Two monsters in the ring, and we have Rhino vs. Abyss right now.
Oh, man, they could tear this house down before it started. Look at the Rhino. He is ready.
He's going to hit. He wants to hit the what? The gore.
He's ready for it. He's ready to gore him now. And a... What?
I hear the music. What's going on, Eric?
Wait a minute. I don't know what's going on here. This isn't on my court.
What?
Jesus Christ.
Business is about to pick up here, Eric. Hey, Daniels and AJ are not in the ring. What is Team 3D want?
I have no idea what they are doing here right now. They said absolutely nothing, Doug, about Rhino and Abyss. They said they had a challenge. They had a challenge for Styles and Daniels. It did not include Rhino and Abyss. What they're doing here at this point in time is beyond me.
I mean, Rhino hates Abyss. And we know there's history between Rhino and Team 3D.
And there's a lot of history between Abyss and Team 3D as well, Doug. They have been feuding over the last several months down south. Well, Doug, the good news is, no matter what they're here for, I'm sure with Brother Ray in the house and a live microphone at ringside, we're about to find out.
Look at this, the crowd behind Team 3D. Team 3D basically built this building here. They have had probably the most hardcore, innovative matches ever seen in Philadelphia. They pretty much ruled Philly in the 90s.
Hey, Doug, you know, if it wasn't for them and a lot of others, we wouldn't be sitting here right now lighting the fuse at PWX.
Oh, he's got the mic.
Go
nowhere,
go
nowhere,
go
nowhere,
go nowhere, go
nowhere. It's very nice to be back. Thank you. I'm really, really pissed off about that last match that was just in here, because me and Devon invented all those things you just saw. All that fucking flying and hoochie-coo shit, we did that before anybody made us move.
get on me, but I didn't quit. Why? Because I did it my way. And in TNA, I do it my fucking way.
Rhino and Abyss. First, we call you the motherfucking Dudleyz.
Doug, when would you know Rhino or Abyss to back down from a challenge? It does not surprise me whatsoever with what we are about to see.
And I just can't believe that Rhino and Abyss are teaming together. These guys hate each other. And what a treat, what a match we have here. Team 3D versus Abyss and Rhino right here in PWX.
Absolutely, Doug, and a lot more on the line than meets the eye, because if you're Team 3D, you want to walk out here and brag about what you've done and accomplished, and rightfully so, throw challenges around and then walk out losing in the house that you helped build, a lot on the line in this matchup.
Definitely Team 3D, they did call out Daniels and AJ, and Daniels and AJ did not accept the challenge. Team 3D said they would fight the Road Warriors, they would fight the Steiners if they were asked to fight them.
The Nasty Boys, they threw the Nasty Boys out there, don't forget about the Nasty Boys.
Kind of almost, maybe not a cheap shot towards those guys, but you gotta say Daniels and AJ, they gotta be a little pissed off at what Team 3D has said. And I just can't wait to see what happens. You never know what's going to happen tonight.
Well, Doug, just the fact that Team 3D walked through those doors from the locker room to the arena and are out here now competing just shows you how important PWX is, because it's not every day you see Team 3D anymore. They pick their spots. They only appear and show up to the important events, and that's got to say something about the importance and prestige of PWX lighting the fuse this evening.
And this action is going all over the building, just like it was 10 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
And this is extreme.
Oh, absolutely, Doug. And, you know, you and I, we've both watched many, many of the greatest brawls in this building with the Team 3D involved, whether it was the Gangstas, the Eliminators, whether it was with each other, Balls and Axel, they threw down and they were successful against everybody, Doug. But you never know, could it be the night for Rhino and Abyss? Because if you're Rhino, you also don't want to come back to this house, a house where you became a name, where you made yourself a superstar and walk out of here a loser.
Hey, Rhino was the ECW World Champion when ECW went out of business, so he's no slouch himself.
Like two eras, Doug, coming together, like two worlds coming together. The Team 3D world of the prior history of this building, and when they kind of walked out of here and went on to other pastures, it was Rhino and his crew that made a name for themselves in this building.
We want to talk about tag teams. I mean, yes, Abyss and Rhino, that is what you call, I guess, a makeshift tag team. And these guys, this is a powerful team, kind of like Bruiser Brody and Stan Hansen.
Oh, that's, you imagine that match? Oh, yeah, that's a great comparison right there. And you know what? What's really interesting, Doug, about this matchup here is Team 3D, Abyss and Rhino, they're very alike as tag teams. Both brawlers, both powerhouses, both will do anything to get the job done, will take risks when necessary. They're both very alike as tag teams.
And now the chairs are in play here. The action is broken down here in Philadelphia. And Brother Ray into the rail.
Oh, absolutely. And Doug, it is always a rare event when Brother Ray stands in the ring or outside of the ring with a wrestler in which he is outsized. And I think that is the case tonight with him at Abyss.
Side slam on the chair.
Oh, yeah.
Only a two count.
Oh, no. And, of course, we have Jim's twin brother, John Finnegan, in there officiating the action.
Sorry.
And thank goodness for that. Look at that back elbow out of Brother Ray. Headbutt!
You don't see him use the headbutt all that often.
Not at all. Not at all. And I gotta tell you, Doug, you know, back in the day when I shared a ring with Team 3D, at one point in Buffalo, New York, Brother Ray almost made me crap my pants being that close to the ring with Brother Ray.
Oh, the best! Oh, low blow. And Rhino with a suplex.
Belly to belly right there. My point being, Doug, that Team 3D are just so intimidating against anybody else, because if you're in there with Rhino and Abyss, you're equally intimidated. So you have two teams right here, Doug, with no fear against one another. You have two teams right here so equally matched, Doug. This is truly a dream match here this evening at PWX.
And a two count right there, and you want to talk about intimidate. You should have seen me one night at 2 o'clock in the morning in Fort Lauderdale on A1A when the late, great Big Dick Dudley and Bubba Ray came up in a Cadillac and said, "Hey, we're going late night after hours clubbing, Doug. You're coming with us." I almost shit myself at time, too.
Well, Doug, you know, don't take this personally, but nobody wants to see you at 2 o'clock in the morning.
I know. Well, it's always dark. That's why I usually...
Right.
Hey, I thought we got girls.
It's like the cherry bombs. They all look better with the lights out.
Commentators.
commentators, right?
Six big commentators. And Brother Ray now with a chair. And Doug, how accustomed is Brother Ray to having fan participation in his matches?
As much as Barry Bonds is with steroids, I guess.
Excuse me?
Sorry.
And a big rake to the mask there from Brother Ray. Does not show any fear or intimidation whatsoever, nor should he with his reputation against the animal, the beast Abyss. And there you go, Rhino right now, who is taking a lot of punishment from Brother Devon. And Doug, a table's in play. Could we see fire?
Possibly, I hope not. It's hot enough. And what a smart move there by Rhino, pushing the table out of the way. Ooh, double clothesline.
Oh, Doug, you start to feel the tide change. Maybe, just maybe T3D gave them their best shot, and now it's Rhino's turn. Is it gore, Doug?
It could be.
Is it gore time? He has scored some of the best in this business, and they were unable to kick out. Doug, I question whether Brother Ray or Brother Devon can kick out of a gore.
Probably one of the most devastating maneuvers of professional wrestling.
Uh-oh.
And Brother Ray beats the table.
He's getting ready for it.
He's going to set off for the gore.
Gore!
Oh, he gored his own. He gored Abyss. It's his partner.
Was that intentional, Doug?
I don't know.
3D!
That's it. Right there, Team 3D is victorious here. Nobody gets up from the 3D.
What a fight. What a dog fight here tonight in this historic building, Doug. But again, I throw the question out there. Congratulations to Team 3D on a very decisive victory. Bucked in Rhino for his partner on purpose.
And it's Christopher Daniels and AJ Styles watching. Because if they are, they will be intimidated.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.